Usman was a student here of this our great and noble institution. He completed this school and he was a Muslim here, and he is still a Muslim here. Please honor Yahya Usman. After completion in the 2016 year group, they were the first computer science student group of this institution. After completion, he was the best student of computer science department 2016 year group. That notwithstanding, he also had the overall best student of the School of Applied Arts. He had the overall best student of the School of Applied Science and Technology of this great institution. That notwithstanding, Honorable Yahya Usman, in fact, he's really honorable. Honorable Yahya Usman made it to be the champ of the whole STU. In fact, the year 2016 group, Honorable Yahya Usman was the overall best student of the Sunyani Technical University. Please, if such a personality is in our midst, we should applaud him. If we have such a personality in our midst, let's applaud him.
Allahu Akbar.
Yes. But then, I hope, Jumsa, members of this, our great hall, now, we would let Honorable Yahya know that that record will be broken this year. So please, Honorable Yahya, the floor is yours. We will give him the opportunity to come and give us a lecture on the journey to the land of success. Please, let's give him a listening ear. He's the calm type. He's very disciplined.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Mr. Chairman and the high table. I find it difficult to talk about the topic that has been given to me, because the topic is very broad, and we have in our midst better people who could do better than I'm coming to do, because we have our lecturers here. They are all capable of talking about that topic, and I have been given the chance to do that. So for that matter, I wouldn't refuse the offer. I will do that on their behalf. If there is any correction, they will do that for me. But before I go, the topic says the journey to the land of success. The journey to the land of success. The topic, as you all agree with me, is very broad. So it's very, very broad. And I can't talk about it. So I'm going to limit the land of success to our academic achievement in our campus. Because we have already even, one of our speakers, Madam Asana, our mother, has already taught us, she has already told us the land to success. And what is it? She talks about discipline. Discipline. If you are disciplined, there is nothing you can achieve on earth. Discipline. The word disciplined, it entails, if you are disciplined, nothing can be left unachieved. So far, as I said, we are students. Our main aim of being here is to achieve academic excellence. So I'll just limit the topic to our life on campus. How are we going to do? At the end of our stay here, we'll go home being proud of ourselves. Jimsa, entire himself be proud of us, and our parents too will also be proud of us. So I'm just going to mention three things. If you upheld these three things, you will achieve whatever you come here to achieve. And as I told you, the mother of all of them is discipline, as our mother told us. And how are you going to be disciplined? You get that? So, first of all, and one of them, I said one of them is discipline, and one is also sacrifice. You have to make a lot of sacrifice. And another one is also determination. The determination is part of the discipline. And above all is submission of all your matters to Allah. If whatever you are going to achieve here, you sacrifice, you determine, and you pray, Allah will make it achievable to you. That is it. So this we are going to talk about these three things, or these four ways. So first of all, we first of all thank God that we are Muslims. So if you are a Muslim, the meaning of Muslims, I'm not all that learned in the Quran, but as our chief that is clearly told us, the Quran is now what? It's English. You can also learn, or you can also read and understand without knowing the Arabic language. So when we talk of Islam or a Muslim, it's simple, means total submission of your affairs to the Almighty Allah. So if you're a Muslim, we'll consider that you have fully submitted everything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what you are going to do here, pray, put God first. Put God first. Okay, so I wouldn't talk about much about about God, for that one they will leave it to our imams. They will enlighten us on that. And what I've come to do is that I said you have to be determined in order to achieve what you plan to achieve. You have, first of all, you have to determine what am I going to determine, or what am I going to achieve. So if you make a target for yourself and you determine towards it, you are going to achieve it. Our brothers, especially those who are freshers, you are here. You never taken exams here, but our brothers in second year and third year, they know what it entails. When you come here, they have every semester they are going to assess you on whatever you have been taught in that semester. And at the end of the day, you are going to get what we call a GPA for that particular semester. If there are so many semesters being put together, that is where we now get the CGPA. So if you want to make a difference, if you want to be the best among the best, what you have to do is that this semester, the semester has just begun, what you are going to do is that you know that at the end of the semester, you have to be in a particular category of our assessment. Whether you are in second class lower, you are in second class upper, you are in first class, or you are at the pass. You get that? So what you first of all, in the beginning of the semester, you have to say that this semester I'm going to get first class for the semester. Every semester is having a class. I'm going to get a first class for the semester. What will give you the first class is if your GPA for a particular semester is from 4.00 to 5.00, you are within the first class what category. You are in the first class category. And how do you achieve that? We don't achieve that if you are not disciplined, as Madam said it. So how do you achieve that? First of all, you have to take attendance to class very serious. First of all, you have to attend lectures. when you go for lecture, so attendance lectures should be what? Should be taken serious. You don't just get up or today, I don't feel like going for lecture. You get that? Do you know that? Because when I wanted to even talk about the student handbook, if especially our first years, please, very soon the student handbook will be given to you, and it's your Bible as a student. It's your Bible as a, it's a Bible to you or a Quran to you as a student. So what you have to do is that if you take the student handbook, all the rules and regulations of on campus is there, as our chief secretary told us, and academic processes, how you are going to do the assessment, everything is there. So when you read it and you adhere to it, at the end of the day, you are going to be what? Among the best. So as I was saying, how do you attend lectures? And the premise of that handbook, they got to know that as a student here, before you succeed, you must attend lectures. You must attend what? Lectures. That is why they put it in the student handbook that if you absent yourself more than 70% in the semester, in a particular course, the lecturer has the right to sack you not to write his exams. You get that? The lecturer has the what? The right to sack you not to do what? Not to write exams. So attendance to class and lectures is very important. And when you are going for lecture, you don't just do that. My colleagues are going for lecture, I'm also going for lecture. You get that? I always say it when I meet my colleagues in the class for the first time, I always ask them, some of us, especially at the beginning of the semester, someone will be going for lecture that because they have just put it in the platform that there is a lecture. It's just going. You don't even know the lecture is going for. It has happened to me before. We were sitting in a class. A colleague, that was the first lecture we were having. Meanwhile, the friend, he was having the temple. He was asking me, that one lecture do we have? You get that? In the first place, you don't even know what is coming to learn. You see that? So how do you do? How are you there? Or why are you there? You see that? And there is a saying that if you are going, you don't know where you are going, you will never get to where you are going. You get that? So you should know what you are coming to learn by learning ahead of the lectures. We have to always learn ahead of the lectures. So you don't just go to lectures. You learn ahead of the lectures. That is why the handout is given to us. And most is for our learning for now, they are not giving any handout. But the beginning of every course, the lecturer will read out to you what you are going, the course outline of the semester. So as a student, as a serious student, what you have to do is that go and start learning ahead of the lecture. So when you come to class, you only have a fair idea of what the lecturer is coming to teach you, so that your mind is already prepared to do this or to grab this. You get that? Like example, you were coming to the meeting here. You get that? And the theme of today's meeting is about discipline, the lost property of what? Muslim Ummah on campus here. You get that? So if you are coming and you know that they are going to talk about discipline, you've already prepared your mind about what? About discipline. So whatever the speaker is going to talk about, that will be grabbed by you. You get that? But if you are just going, you are going for lecture, you don't even know what you are going for. You see that? You find it difficult. And now we are lucky that the information is now available to us. We are lucky. We are lucky in the sense that technology has made everything easy for us. It's not like our lecturers, they suffered. Though their time there was technology, but they didn't have access to phones like we are having. You see that? If you ask most of them, maybe their first degree, when they were taking their first degree, they didn't even have smartphones. If they were having phones, it was a young phone. You get that? But now, almost all of us here, we have smartphones. So we have to make good use of the phones that we have. We have to make good use of the phone. Whatever, if you Google everything, you get an information about it. You get that? If you Google everything, you get information about it from Google. So Google is our universal our universal lecture, and we have to make good use of Google. And I wanted to ask a particular question. I'll ask the question maybe at the end of the lesson here. Okay, so how do you achieve success? We have talked about how do you achieve success on campus here. We have talked about being what consistent to lectures. You have to always attend lectures. So if you go to lecture, don't go to lecture hall and be what's happening. If you go to lecture hall, please sacrifice, just sacrifice the 3 hours or the 2 hours of your time. Just put your phone aside. Listen to the lecture. Every bit of what the lecturer said will be grabbed by you. But some of us, most of our colleagues, they'll be sitting in the class, they're what's happening. You see that a human mind, you can't achieve what's more than one thing at the same time. You get that? So it's either that you be in your dormitory, what's happening, or you are in the lecture hall, stop everything and listen to the lecture. You get that? And some of us here, when we are also in the lecture hall, apart from WhatsApp, we do a lot of what? Unless we just be chatting. Some of us, we don't like, that is why when we come to lecture, some of us, we don't like sitting in the front what? In the front line. You get that? We are always backward ventures. You get that? But as every serious student, you have to always sit in front. Because what the lecturer is saying will be grabbed by you if you are sitting in the front. So always, you have to sit in the front. So I'll throw it as a challenge to you as Muslim brothers and sisters on campus here. I want to see all of you. Every lecture we attend, the first row should be filled by what? Muslim brothers and sisters. So we have to take that into consideration. And I'm throwing a challenge to you. We have to always be in the what? In the front line. That is why when I was here, I never been to class late. And when I even go to class, I will not sit at the back. You see that? You will all be with me. A class of more than 100 students, the back is always noisy. The back is always noisy. So if you are a serious student, when you are even there, those disturbances, don't disturb you, they will disturb you, you can't hear. So how do you what do? How do you stay away from them? You have to always come early before the what the lecturer comes and occupy the what from this. I hope we get that. Okay. And apart from that, what you have to also do is that second thing is also that you have to know yourself. You have to do what? You have to know yourself. You have to know yourself in the sense that you should know the term. You study and you assimilate it or you trap it. Some of us, we are just don't just go to class because your colleagues are going to class. Some of us, you have to if you are going to know yourself in the sense that some of us they are very good in studying in daytime. When they study in daytime, they grab it. Some of us when they study in the nighttime, they grab it. Do you get that? So knowing yourself that, so if I'm such a person, if I learn in the what? In the daytime, I get it. So you have to schedule your time. Always learn in the what? In the daytime. You get that? And if you're also a one who learned in the night, you have to also schedule your time. Put necessary things aside and also learn in the night. Okay. And let me just summarize this because I have been told that I have 1 minute remaining. So, in all this, time management is very important. Time management is very important. We have to make good use of our time. You get that? So you see that for time, that is why Americans will say that time is what? Time is money. You get that? And you see that the time is given to us, the 24 hours is given to all of us. But depending on how you use it, that makes the difference. You see that successful person make good use of their time. So when you are a student here, you have to make sure that I'm here for a reason. You don't let WhatsApp you don't like Facebook, you don't like Manchester United, Barcelona, or whatever, that is not productive to you. Don't spend much of your time on unproductive work matters. Then let's just analyze it. Let's look at, I said we have 24 hours being given to all of us, but how we make use of it, that is where the difference lies. Let me ask a question. We have 24 hours within the day. So the 24 hours, how many times do you use to pray Zuri? How many times do you use to pray Asr, Maghrib, Isha, all of them, Fajr? So if you listen, if you just come, take all the five prayers, it will not take you more than 2 hours. Imam Ali, it will not take you more than 2 hours. So let's just say, all the five daily prayers takes you what? 1 hour. So 1 minus 24, how many left? 23. And we have been advised that at least under normal circumstances, health professionals advise that at least you have to sleep what? Normal sleep hours is what? 7 to 8 hours. Is that not all? 6 to 8 hours. So let's take the 8 hours. 8 plus 1 is what? 9. So 9 plus 9 minus 25, 24 is what? 9 minus 24. We have 15. So the 15 hours. Where do you use the 15 hours for? You get that? The 9 hours that I've mentioned is very compulsive. You can't do away with sleep. You can't do away with prayers. So now, the 15 hours, what do you use it for? You get that? So meaning that if we make good use of these 15 hours as students, there's nothing that we can achieve. Not only was on campus here, but you make good use of these 15 hours that we've all analyzed. You are going to make a difference. You get that? So meaning that, so now the 15 hours, let's say the 15 hours, so let's say you are taking 5 hours, let's misuse the 5 hours, or let's use the 5 hours as our leisure time. The 10 hours, what do you use it for? You get that? So if you analyze it that way, you know that we are misusing our time so much. We are misusing our time so much. You get that? So that is the problem. So I wouldn't talk much. So if you analyze the time is very important. So if you analyze your time like that and you like this and you make good use of it, at the end of the day, you will not compile notes and you wait till when it is quiz time, you now be going to class and be doing TDBs. You see that, till daybreak. You see that? So if you go for a lecture today, as the 10 hours of the 15 hours, if you make good use of that one, you will not compile what? Lecture notes. So the end of the semester, you're now running here, I was here and there to learn to cover all the courses that you have done for that particular semester. You get that? So we have to always plan ahead of what? Time. We have to plan ahead of time. And if you plan ahead of time, Madam also mentioned something, and I'll talk about that. Exam malpractice. Exam practice. Please, brothers and sisters and sisters, we should never, especially our brothers who are in first year, we should never involve ourselves in exam practice. Even if you are not prepared for a particular course and it's time for exams, just go and write whatever you know. If you get a receipt, it's better than you involving yourself in exam malpractice and they are calling you for this in the disciplinary committee. If they call you for a disciplinary committee, the probability of you being suspended for a whole academic year is very high. When you look at the amount of fees that we pay for a particular semester, you pay the fees, at the end of the day, they suspend you, you go home and come back for one academic year. You see that you just wasted that year, like that. You get that? So, our first year, please, exam practice, never. It's very shameful that when they paste names of those who are involved in exam malpractice and you go and it's a brother, it's a, what they call it, a Muslim brother or a sister, it's very shameful. So we have to always make what? Islam proud, but not involving ourselves in all things that are not allowed on campus. Without much ado, I will just stop here and thank brothers for your time. Thank you very much.
التكبير التكبير
الله أكبر
We thank our brother on our